broadcast with the news that is just coming in from Jammu and Kashmir, where three attacks have taken place in a span of 24 hours and four non-local laborers have been killed. In the recent attack, three non-local laborers were targeted who hail from Bihar. The attack took place in Kulgam district of Jammu and Kashmir. While two succumbed to their injuries, one is still critically injured. Let's first play out the reactions that are coming in.
वहाँ पे हम लोग रूम पे बैठे हुए थे, अचानक ये लोग आया उधर से दौड़े हुआ, बोलता गोली लग गया इनको, फिर वहाँ से लेके हमारे डॉक्टर के।
तो कितने बंदों का गोली लग गई है?
लगभग वहाँ तीन आदमी थे सर।
तो अभी क्या स्थिति है उनकी?
उनकी तो वो दो का पता नहीं लग रहा।
तो आप लोग कहाँ पे रहते हो?
हम लोग वनपू मार्केट में रहते हैं अंदर।
काम क्या करते हो आप लोग?
मजदूरी स्लेब का।
अच्छा, घर कहाँ है आपका?
बिहार।
तो कितने बंदों पर दर्द?
तीन बंदे पे हमला हुआ।
हमलावर तीन थे?
हाँ
भाई, उधर कोई गोली मारा है, उधर से आया भागे हुए। हाँ, 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 रूम में था।
हाँ, हाँ,
तो उसको लेकर मैं आया हूँ
जी। तो क्या कहाँ पे लगी उसको?
उसको गोली अनफू में लगी है।
कितने फायर आए उसको?
छे
छे
हाँ छे।
आप कहाँ से हो? आप कहाँ रहते हो?
मैं बिहार से।
आप बिहार से हो?
हाँ।
तो उसके बाद क्या हुआ वहाँ पे?
उसके बाद मैं नहीं जानता हूँ।
तो कितने बंदे थे वहाँ पे?
वहाँ पे तीन बंदे थे।
अच्छा,
तीन बंदे थे।
बंदूकबरदार कितने बंदे थे? बंदूकबरदार
बलुकमंदार उसी को पता है सर, हमको पता नहीं, वो मेरे पास है, मैं रूम में था।
आप क्या काम करते हो?
मैं स्लेब का।
पाकिस्तानी आतंकवादियों ने एक बार फिर जघन्य अपराध किया है और कश्मीर घाटी में अपनी मेहनत के बल पर रोजी रोटी कमाने वाले मजदूरों की जिस प्रकार नृशंस हत्या की है, ये बहुत बड़ा जघन्य अपराध इन पाकिस्तान के कायर आतंकवादियों ने किया है। चुन चुन कर इन आतंकवादियों का भी हम सफाया करेंगे। दुर्रांत आतंकवादियों को चुकानी पड़ेगी। सबका हिसाब बराबर करेंगे और सूद समेत।
पाकिस्तानी प्रीमियर हु हैज बीन क्राइंग अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, सर्टेन सेपरेटिस्ट हैंडलर्स हु हैव बीन क्लेमरिंग अबाउट जिहाद इन कश्मीर, इज दिस वी कुड से व्हाट दे कॉल finding a solution to the Kashmir issue by murdering, by butchering innocent, unarmed and hapless poor laborers. Let me affirm and assure each and every non-Kashmiri and minorities living in Kashmir that these terror handlers shall be neutralized at the earliest possible note. They will find the logical conclusion very soon.
Virendra Paswan ji, Arvind Sah ji, उसके बाद ऋषिदेव परिवार को जिस तरीके से लगातार निशाना बनाया गया है, उनकी हत्या की गई है, हमारे सुरक्षा बल हमारे इन बिहारी भाइयों के एक एक खून का बदला लेंगे और मुंहतोड़ जवाब देंगे और कश्मीर से आतंकवाद का खात्मा होगा, इस बात का हमें पूरा विश्वास है। बिहार के आदरणीय मुख्यमंत्री श्री नीतीश कुमार जी से भी हम आग्रह करते हैं कि 2 लाख रुपये की जो अनुग्रह राशि हमारे इस श्रमिक भाइयों की हत्या पर उनके परिजनों को दी जा रही है, उसमें बढ़ोतरी की जाए।
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 1 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Well, let's first go across to my colleagues. We have Ishan, Pradeep and Sohil joining us with live updates. We have Major General GD Bakshi as well. Let me first take an update from Ishan. Ishan, tell us, what is the situation of the person who was critically injured? Two have succumbed to their injuries while one was critically injured in this attack.
Well, he's being treated at the government college Anantnag. He had also sustained bullet injury. Two of them we already know had some while they were on their way home. Now, locals who brought them here have said that they were in third condition when they were taken to the hospital. They were having symptoms and above the means it's difficult for them to leave. Following that, police in the area, but to attack the escape, but the grid now will have to go hurdle and think about the future strategies of attacks. Yesterday we saw that
Ishan, we're losing your audio. It could be due to the network issue. But stay on with us. We'll fix that. I'll come right back to you. Meanwhile, let me take an update from Sohil. Sohil, what are you picking up as far as the terror organization responsible for this attack is concerned? This is a third attack in a span of 24 hours. So far, four non-local laborers have been killed by terrorists.
Absolutely, Swati, in the last couple of days, 10 civilians have been shot dead in Kashmir Valley, be it in Srinagar City and other parts of Kashmir Valley. In fact, in South Kashmir as well yesterday, a carpenter from Uttar Pradesh, Saharanpur, was shot dead in Pulwama, and today again in Vanpu area of Kulgam district, that too in South Kashmir, two have been shot dead. And the third person, the third non-local resident, who is also a laborer, is being attended by a team of doctors at district hospital Anantnag, though a doctor say his condition is critical. But IG Kashmir Range Vijay Kumar has called a meeting, and in fact at this point in time all the situations are being reviewed, because we have seen in Srinagar City as well yesterday a non-local vendor who was a Pani Puri seller was shot dead in Eidgah area, and again today there are attacks on the non-local residents. So it shows that the militants have geared up for their activities to target non-residents, so which is creating a problem, because Jammu and Kashmir for the last couple of years has a huge population of people who have come from different parts of country to make their earnings. So now as these non-locals are being targeted, it's certainly a cause of concern. And in fact recently when Makhanlal Bindru was shot dead at his at his store in Srinagar City, that time a top team of intelligence officials had camped in Srinagar for a week. And then after that meeting, Jammu and Kashmir police and paramilitary forces, they intensified the operations in southern Kashmir, because the Jammu and Kashmir police had input that all those militants who were involved
the death of some civilians also have been avenged by our forces. I want to bring in Pradeep Datta as well. Pradeep, are these attacks against Hindus and Sikhs in the valley, are these attacks under against the non-locals in the valley?
See, Swati, one has to understand what they are trying to achieve. One, they are trying to generate fear psychosis. They are trying to destabilize the situation. They are trying to trigger unrest. And they are further trying to widen the gulf between the Kashmiris and the rest of the people in the rest of India. So that's what they are trying to do. And now you have to see that why they are carrying out these attacks against non-Kashmiris. What, one, they are trying to prove a point that this normalcy narrative is nothing. It's far from reality. And they are trying to tell the world that all is not well after the abrogation of Article 370. And all this is happening just ahead of Home Minister Amit Shah's visit to Kashmir Valley on 24th of this month, where he's going to, for the first time, come after abrogation of Article 370. And the second thing is they are trying to spin a demographic change narrative so that they can justify their act of killing. But if in reality you look at these things, this is nothing but is a radical Islamist template that is being replicated here. We have seen this thing happening in Afghanistan, we have seen this thing happening in Pakistan, and now the same thing is happening in Kashmir Valley too. So they are targeting Hindus. Why I'm saying they are targeting Hindus, if you look at all these killing, whether it was Makhanlal Bindru, whether it was Pani Puri Wala yesterday, Arvind, whether it was a few days back Paswan, Virendra Paswan, all of them had been Hindus. The second thing has been that they are targeting Hindustanis, whether it's a Kashmiri Muslim or an Indian Muslim.
Right.
Whosoever believes in the idea of one India, they are targeting them. Whosoever is carrying a Tiranga in heart is being targeted. And then they are trying to target Hindustan, because Hindustan means diversity, composite culture, pluralistic culture. They are trying to target that also. That's why they are carrying out this killing, because in the 90s also we saw that they have raised slogan for Nizam-e-Mustafa. That time also they wanted people of one particular faith only to live
Absolutely.
There. That's one of the reasons that 5 lakh Kashmiri Hindus had to abandon their huts and home. The same thing they are doing right now also, generating fear, widening fault lines.
Let's get General Bakshi's response on this as well, and his view on whether this is, General Bakshi, a response to the fact that terrorists, their top commanders are being neutralized in the valley, and in a desperate attempt to create fear, to generate fear in the minds of people who are now looking at Kashmir as an option to settle down maybe, or to earn a living there. Is that to drive those people out? Is that the reason you see behind this sudden spike in attacks that are taking place?
Look, the simple fact is that they tried attacks against the security forces and they got a bloody nose. So now they are leaving the security forces alone. They have found the softest targets are these poor laborers, these vendors of bhelpuri, pani puri, those who run medical shops, those who are principals in school, softest targets, unarmed. They come with pistols which are supplied to them and taken away after the attack is over. You know, it is like a section of the terrorist and their overground network have become rabid dogs. They are biting all and plundering. There is nothing sophisticated or justifiable about this stupid strategy. It is ethnic cleansing. It is just targeting the minority community, and it is reprehensible. It is the action of mad, rabid dogs. Hmm. And then the only answer is to treat them like rabid dogs, to shoot them at sight.
General Bakshi, right? No doubt our forces are going to avenge these killings and attacks, but how are they going to ensure safety and security for the non-locals, especially as of now, because they've come under attack? Because, you know, what, according to you, could be the option, the strategy that the forces could adopt?
Look, there is very little you can do to provide security to labor scattered all over. If you
General Bakshi, you're not audible anymore. I can't hear you. Okay, let's in fact go across to Pradeep now. Pradeep, General Bakshi was saying that it's very little that you know, we can do to provide security to these non-local laborers. Why is that the case?
See, the laborers are spread all over Kashmir Valley. It's not easy to provide security personnel to each and every laborer. What they can do is right now they have to strengthen the counter-terror grid that's in Kashmir Valley. And besides that, they will have to once again go back to the chessboard and look at the security scenario. And accordingly, they have to frame a policy how they can, one, generate the confidence of the people that has been shattered because of these killings of minority community members and also non-Kashmiris. And also they have to ensure that how they can get after this overgrown network, because they have to improve their intelligence network, because reason being that these terrorists are now adopting a new strategy that's called the hybrid warfare, where the part-time terrorists are being used. These overgrown workers, they do not have any terror record, so they can easily checkmate security agency. When there is no terror record, they just hold pistol and easily mingle with the population after carrying out the act of terror. That's exactly what is happening. Most of the time, you will not find all the top terror commanders being involved. Why this thing is happening? They very well know that they will not be able to match might of security forces. We have seen that whenever there has been encounter, most of these terror commanders get killed. During 9 days, 9 encounters, 13 of these terror commanders have been eliminated, which includes Mushtaq Hande, who was involved in the killing of two police personnel, and also Sham Sofi, a Jaish Mohammed terrorist.
Right. So there were inputs that the terrorists, the terror organizations are now using the overground workers for these targeted killings. Let's go back to General Bakshi. We lost your audio there for a while, sir. Please finish your point that you were making earlier.
The point that I was trying to make is that it is impossible to go and protect every single civilian target scattered. You may defend the labor camps, they will hit the shops. You will defend the shops, they will hit the schools. So the targets are multiple. Mm. That is not the answer. It is a waste of time to try and go around protecting every single individual. You can't do it. What you can definitely do is you single out these people who are carrying out the attack. You go for them in a ruthless manner and you shoot to kill. You shoot to kill. There are adequate, you know, surveillance cameras. Hmm. And don't tell me that we have not been able to pick up these people till now. It is impossible that we have every single camera is off. We will be able to get input on these, and the security forces to focus on killing those who are doing the killing. That is the only way to protect your population. Hmm. Go for those who are killing your people. Kill them first. And if you can't preempt, kill them the fastest possible. But you have to kill rabbit dogs.
We need to give a befitting response to these terrorists, and the crackdown on the terror organizations and their top commanders need to be intensified. Well, Home Minister Amit Shah would be on a visit to Jammu and Kashmir on the 23rd and 24th of October. Ahead of that, these targeted killings are taking place. One, of course, is also going to very, very carefully monitor and track that visit of Home Minister Amit Shah. And high-level meetings, of course, would also take place to, at this point in time, strategize and upgrade the security in the valley. With that, we're slipping into a very short break. Thank you very much to General Bakshi, to Pradeep, Ishad and Sohil for getting us the details.